Well, hello, good people. Mark Holmes here, and as always, I want to thank you all for watching, commenting, subscribing, and being part of the Jobu Sports Report. Without you guys, as well as you ladies, you know that this literally, and I mean literally, does not work. We are actually here in our outdoor studio, just trying to see if it works. In fact, I've been putting everything back together here. The weather's warmed up a bit, and we're definitely going to be using this like we used to. So let's try. Let's do a little test run here.
He looked great. He looked like Miles Sanders. He looked great. Now, the one thing that may come from Miles Sanders' injury, which is a hamstring injury, which kept him out of a lot of the OTAs and minicamp last year. What the hell did that door just shut for? Did you hear that? A shut door just opened and shut. Nobody's around.
Philly, you are so funny, Philly. Let me just double check, because like I said, I'm trying to see, make sure that everything still works in here. Yes, it still shows my pot belly and everything else. Got to work on the camera angles and stuff, but definitely it is coming together again, and hopefully the sound sounds okay, and we'll be able to do our thing, because we are a stone cold New York rap machine. So here's what's cool. I've been sitting here thinking, I've been talking a lot with my man DMV, and DMV and I, we're going to be doing a bunch of things together, a lot more things together than we used to in the past. And I honestly cannot wait to do some more stuff, because DMV is a wealth of knowledge, being a high school coach and working with kids going off to college, play college football and things. He is great at breaking down film and having just a wealth of knowledge and things with football. What I'm hoping for, and maybe this is hope without merit, I'm hoping that Kellen Moore, because this is where I think everything is going to be, how our season succeeds or fails, is will Kellen Moore actually evolve? Kellen Moore has to understand that we have to be more than 3 yards in a cloud of dust with Zeke Elliott. That Zeke Elliott is not the same back that he was 5 years ago. He still can be a very productive back. I think about when we went through and we got Darren McFadden, who was getting about 3.9 yards a carry for 3 years straight. When we brought him in and made him a 1,000-yard running back, and we were one of the top teams at running the football, I believe that we can get there with Zeke. But the thing about the Dallas Cowboys has always been, we just want to line up man on man, hat on hat, and we just want to be able to beat you physically. That used to work in the 90s, because the Cowboys were able to, without a salary cap, have wave after wave of great player and just literally just bludgeon teams to death. Now the players in the situation is so watered down that you can't just do that anymore. You have to be where the other team is not. And you have to be able to cover all of your bases. And herein lies the conundrum that is the Dallas Cowboys, the enigma, so to speak. The Cowboys are going to have to get dynamic with the offense. They're going to have to start using the tools and realizing the things that they do best. When I look at the numbers for Dak Prescott, hurry-up offense has always been great for the Dallas Cowboys. 12 personnel using two tight ends has always been great for the Dallas Cowboys for a multitude of reasons. One, you can do almost anything out of it. You can play action, you can run, you can pass, you can get five wideouts actually if you wanted to out of it. And that, my friends, is the difference of winning and losing. When you think about somebody like Bill Belichick, it's not that he gets the best players in football and just lines up every week in the same formation and just bludgeons you to death. He's going to throw things that you have never seen before at that, and he's also really good at, you know, spying and getting everything out that he can. But they keep you on your toes. They are going to be where you're not going to be. And that's what the Cowboys have not done in forever. The Cowboys, the history of the Cowboys was being innovators. Tom Landry understood we have to evolve and put players in positions to succeed. He could take a guy who's struggling at linebacker and ending up creating a defense that uses his linebacking skills by creating the flex defense and taking Randy White and keeping him a little bit further off of the ball so he can see what's going on and being able to make moves. He could take a slow cornerback and turn him into one of the great safeties that we had in a Charlie Waters. He can take an offense and realize I need a little bit more time for my quarterback to be able to make plays. So we will do a shotgun offense. We'll get the quarterback there. He's already standing up. He can survey the field. It's less time that he has to spend getting back there. He can do the shift. And most people don't understand what the shift actually was. It wasn't just going up and going down. Sometimes it was a little bit of a step to the left or a little step to the right because you're going to run the ball, say, in this hole. So we want to cheat out just a little bit, just to give you a little bit more of a crease. It was the Dallas Cowboys going through and finding track stars that they convert into Hall of Fame wide receivers. I ask you, since Jimmy Johnson has left, what have the Dallas Cowboys innovated? What wrinkle can you say that is the Dallas Cowboys MO and signature? And there's not one. And it's now time for Kellen Moore, who's now beyond Jason Garrett. He's now beyond Scott Linehan. He's now beyond being a quarterback for the Detroit Lions. It's time for Kellen Moore to create his own thing, to create his own offense. They'll tell you that Dak is not this good of a quarterback. He's not the guy that's going to lead him and so on. They'll tell you the offensive line is not great. They'll tell you Zeke Elliott's done. Well, I say all that's bullshit because I've seen teams with lesser quarterbacks go further. I've seen teams with lesser offensive lines go further. I've seen teams with lesser running backs go further. It's not only the players on the field. It's going to come down to coaching. And my biggest question going through after seeing this draft, which this draft is really not about this year so much as it is a team building for down the road, is do the Dallas Cowboys' plans truly include Mike McCarthy? Or are the Cowboys building for someone else? I wish I had the answer for that. I guess this will be trial by error. We'll see how it goes. But I don't know. But I do know this much. There's a lot of people with a lot on the line going into the season. Zeke, Kellen Moore, Mike McCarthy. They're going to, Tyron Smith, guys like Tristan Hill. These are guys that it's time to put up or shut up or you're going to be gone and replaced. And that's just the way it is in football. So, I think that this was a decent test run here. And I'm going to turn out the lights here. And I'm going to go spend some time with my wonderful wife. And I'll see you guys later.